Hi and welcome to episode 19 in the Bitwig Studio Basics series. Today let's talk about audio routings in the Bitwig Studio and look at how we can route audio between different audio tracks and from media tracks with VST instruments to other audio tracks in Bitwig Studio. My name is Mattias and this is Morningdew Media. Let's take the tour. Before we get started, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit the like and that notification bell so that you get a notice when I have new videos on this channel. You can also go to my website morningdewmedia.com and there you can sign up to the Morningdew Media Weekly and you will receive a free creative booster guide. You can also check out some of the sound packs that I have for Logic and for Bitwig Studio. And I also have some regular sample packs with WAV files. Okay, so let's talk about the internal routings within Bitwig Studio. And to begin with, we will go up here into the dashboard and look at our audio interface settings. And as you can see here, we have my input device and output device set to a specific aggregate device in OS X here. And if we go to my audio MIDI setup, we can see that my aggregated device consists of the complete audio 6 MK2 and a driver called I Show You Audio Capture. And this is an internal audio device in order to make my routings from the DAW into OBS, which is my video recording software. We can see the sample rate is set to 48 kHz. And here we have the input and output buses, which is currently only one stereo input activated. And we have a few different outputs activated. The complete audio 1 and 2, 3 and 4 as a stereo output, and then the I Show You output. So to record audio onto one of these tracks, when you boot up Bitwig Studio, you have an instrument track, a MIDI track, and this second audio track by default, if you haven't changed this to some custom template. So this is basically our audio track, and it's set to stereo input number 1. So that's, you can see that we have the audio coming in here from my baby bottle microphone here on this first audio track. But as you can see here, we can also select the inputs from our other tracks here. So on this first track, which is a MIDI instrument track, we have a sampler with a piano. So maybe we want to record that audio coming out from this acoustic piano on this second track. In order to do that, we go to this second track and open up our audio input settings. And we can set it to this acoustic piano track, either pre-fader or post-fader. And there's quite a big difference here, because if we set this to pre-fader, it doesn't matter if we drag the volume down here, just reduce it drastically like this, and of course we need to activate the recording on this second track. You can see that even though we drag this to a quite low volume, we still have our regular volume, the gain before this fader. But we can also set that to post fader. So if we go to the second track and activate the acoustic piano nectar and set it to post. So now it will take this volume fader into account when you record the audio to this second track. So let's, if we drag that down, it will be a quite low volume on this recording. So that's the big difference there. And you can also select some more options. If we go into this second track again and go into acoustic piano nectar and select the sampler chain. And here we can actually select where we want to send the audio to our new audio track. And we can see that the reverb is the last effect in this device chain. So basically we could record pre-reverb or after the reverb. So let's select the dynamics out and do another pass of recording here. And now if we listen back to this recording, it will be without the reverb. When our original sound was actually. So that's quite the powerful routing, because you can basically select where you want to send the audio in the chain, in the device chain from this previous track. Because now we were sending it from the output of this dynamics processor rather than sending after post the reverb. So that's the big difference between these two settings. So that's one way to route the audio to this second track. There's also another way, but if you do this the other way with a audio receiver, you won't be able to record the audio to this second track. Because anytime you want to record the audio from another track, you have to do that on this input section of your track at this stage. So that's something to keep in mind when you want to record audio from other tracks into new tracks. But you can, of course, send audio like this too. So let's select the audio acoustic connector and the post. So now if we record a little pause again. So now anytime we listen on this MIDI recording, you can see that we have a volume going on the second track too. But we can't really record this audio. Even if I select record here, if we set this to the stereo input or the no input here, this audio that arrives at this stage, at the device stage, will not be recorded onto your timeline. So we can prove that just by, I mean, if we set this to stereo in, of course it will record the stereo in. And if we set it to this acoustic connector post, it will record via this input, not by this audio receiver. We can't even set this to record if we don't have any inputs here, so let's set it to stereo input. And it will record a microphone, of course. So just keep that in mind. If you want to record the audio from another track, you have to go here and select the input from that previous track. So that's the big difference. Okay, so let's look at another thing here. We can go to the drum machine and look at the routings here, because when you start up this drum machine, you can see that it's a single track with a single track with single audio. It's just a stereo track. But as soon as we load up some samples in here, we can just drag a few here, like this. You can see that we have these dots in the mixer, or these arrows in the mixer. And if we press this icon, you can see that we have all these different separate tracks for all of these drum pads. And you can also use these tracks and send them to another audio track if you want to process it separately. Of course, you can add different plugins at this stage on each of these rows, but you can also send them to, say, let's create a new audio track here and call it drum bus. And the same thing here, just go to the input of the track and go down to the drum machine and select whichever of these tracks you want to send to this new drum bus. So we could send only this closed hi-hat, or maybe the kick here, post fader. So now you can see that we have effectively sent the kick drum to this drum bus via this input, the audio input for this channel. So that's basically how you route different audio tracks in the Bitwig Studio to new tracks. Okay, so that's a quick introduction into the audio routings of Bitwig Studio. It's a very flexible solution, and I think it's a quite good solution because you can basically route any audio tracks into a new audio track very easily and very quickly. If you have any questions on this video, please write that in the comment section below. Now you can continue and watch my next video. My name is Mattias, and see you in the next one. Bye.